continue talk about addictions. If you didn't go to sleep after my previous video, then you deserve really a big gold medal, because I'm gone to sleep after watching my video. Sleep to sleep is quite long, and my voice and this red color can easily drive you to sleep. And if somebody tell you that red color not for relaxing, red color is just for excite you, and so don't believe. Is red color is can be relaxing. It also depends of brain of people. For somebody is relaxing color, for somebody is not. And of course somebody says, oh, red color is an excite bulls. When you showing them red color, no, bulls is even don't understand color. They can see everything maybe without color, because doesn't matter what color, most important for the movement of these claws, they should be really red. So it's the reason why I'm wearing red, to relax you. Because if somebody don't like a red color, they wouldn't watch it. And if you're watching me, if you would like to knew about all different objects what I'm talking about, so you okay then for red color. And if you're going to sleep even and watching my video until end, so that's it, it's work for you. So you can watch it another time, eventually you will see all of them. Oh my goodness, I'm really going to sleep yesterday after watching my video. Oh. So today we will talk about another addiction, about smoking. So as every addiction connected with, of course, brain, a structure of brain. So everything depends, you should know from my previous video about the structures. It's very important, of course, to understand what I'm about. And I won't tell you a big lecture about how is smoking bad addiction, what is cause, because everybody knew that this can cause lung cancer, lips cancer, throat cancer, and all any another problems, you know, like a high blood pressure, problems with the venous and arteries on your feet, for example, a lot. One after another, they just like a chain, switched on each other. So, and for example, my husband, he smoking all his life. And he really wants to stop it, but he can't, because he have this addiction for so many years, and his brain always sent him back, said, yes, go, I have some my nice feelings, I have something which is I can't without, you know. Your little dictator tell you about this all the time, he's strong. And so he have problem with his venous, and you know, his feet all the time cold, because you know, it's nothing even hurt to him. He try even nice warm boots and electric boots, and I don't know, something to warm in his feet, because feelings when your feet all the time cold is not the best one. Of course, I even don't talk about what's in the morning go out of your bronchs, you know, it's absolutely awful, not nice looking substance go out of you, you know. And when I my son. I tell to him all the time, you have a choice. You can smoke, and it's everything allowed in this life. Everything. You can drink, you can do anything. Doesn't matter what, everything allowed. Person have the own responsibility for their life. But as mother, I can just tell you what can happen. And after this is your choice, your responsibility. And when these children understand that they must take some sort of responsibility, they don't like to take any responsibility for anything. They wouldn't do this because they don't want this responsibility. Same I tell to him, I say, okay, if you wouldn't have good mark in school, wouldn't learn very well, it's okay, I would support you anyway. Even if you wouldn't have any money and don't have a job, good job, we can go together in the rubbish bins on the streets or somewhere and go and try to find some sort of a food after people together. He told to me, Mom, what you talk about? You wouldn't have never go to this and do this. I wouldn't do this for you, And it's the way I teach him. I said, yes, doesn't matter what you do, I would support you anyway. Doesn't matter what. I can share with you all your problems, all your difficulties. And I explained to him what can be if he wouldn't learn properly in the school, if he wouldn't, if he would like to smoke, he have his own responsibility, but I still would support you. I told to him, if you have this any problems, I would support you anyway. And when I show into him, when you walk sometimes on the street and some people spitting straight on the street something from their lawn, and if I see it, I never miss it. I always show it to my son. Look at that. It will be in your alarm, in your Bronx. If you would smoke in, and this will be everywhere, lie down. And he look at this and say, ah. So, he growing with this attitude to smoking, and I'm, because when you're not allowed the children doing something, they opposite, they will go and do it. And I'm allowed to him everything and say, yes, okay, you can, it's your responsibility, you can do this, yeah. And so he even don't want to do this. So he, at the moment, 31 years old, and he don't smoke, and he don't drink as well. And so because, it's very important how you teach your children, don't do something which is can harm them, because you're adult and you know what can happen, they don't. But when you teach it, don't be too critical parents, you just very nice advice, but all the time remind that your child will have responsibility, their own responsibility for their life, and all the time tell your children about this. And if you already have got your addiction to smoking, or your friends have, or you can suggest them, go to Pathologer Anatomy one day. Just asking to go there especially to stop smoking, and you would see when you go to Pathologer Anatomy, and see how is a doctor of pathologist, he's cut it down, this person who died from any other reason, but those person was smoke, they would show to you line of this person. person. I see it when I've been student. So when I go it, because I smoke in Riga when I was young, nobody teach me or tell me about smoking problems and not allowed to me to do this because my mom's smoking and she tell me all the time it's no good, smoking is no good, but I see that she smoke, she alive, she okay. Those time I even I don't understand it, and my mom she don't know how to teach so child even don't smoking after what you tell them. You know, she just don't know how to do this. And so, and I smoking when I go to my students comes first and we start, you know, just smoking there a lot, you know, because no any parents, no any somebody who control you and see you and you just alone and do everything what you would like and like adult, you know, and we all smoking. We're smoking about, I don't know, 20 cigarettes per day, and sometimes when we even already don't have cigarettes because the shop was long far away, we found our little bits from our cigarettes. It was little tiny one without filter, you know, because with the filter cigarettes was expensive for students, you know, with cigarettes without it was cheaper, so we buy them. And we even can hold this little end of cigarettes when you don't have, you just take it with the two matches together and hold it to smoke it, you know. I pass it, I know what it means. Addiction is really, you know, just for half a year before we go to pathology anatomy, I smoke, and it's really stay strong with me because I study in my morning these days. First, since before I have a cup of tea or something, we all go to smoking. And when I go to pathology anatomy, and the doctor cut lung of man who died previously from he been on the wedding of his daughter and suddenly died. And he was under alcohol and appears on his lung. He was smoking for so many years because in the lung you can see just how you call it, your lung looks like all in little tiny black worms because those bronchitis, bronchs, little tiny bronchioles, they are very thin and looks like little worms, you know, and they're all full of like coal, you know, it's like a black coal. I don't know, did you seen these special tablets, absorbent, they black like a coal, you know, and when they just when he cut this lung, I hear noise. It's like somebody cutting through the sandpaper. I don't know. Noise of this lung, it was awful. And I look at this, and when he cut this bronchs, and inside of this bronchs, all around this substance, this I don't know. It's something sticky, yellowy, and sometimes almost browny and greeny color everywhere in the Bronx, and you look this and it's awful, and smell from this lung is awful. And when I imagine what I will have in my pink lung very young, I will have all of this? After so many years? Goodness me! I stopped smoking after watching all this. I'm really stop. If you have possibility to go and see this procedure and open line of smoking person, is worth it to see it, to stop smoking forever. Really to say, maybe I'm this person who really accepted to close, I don't know, but it's really really work, and I stopped smoking straight away. That's it. After this, never one cigarette more. So exciting of seeing what I seen was stronger than exciting from smoking in the morning. And suddenly my brain stop dictate me next morning. Don't tell me just go and smoke. Oh, I wanted something like that, but I take all my strength and I don't go, but I want it too much. No, this was metamorphosis. Like this was just, you know, just stop dictate to me, because something what I seen be more stronger excitements is stay in my, is beat those excitements what I had every morning or every day when I smoke cigarette. So you all the time should find something stronger than this one. You can find something which would beat your excitement from some sort of bad addictions. So it's, you know, if something excites you from gambling, that you would win more, you have possibility, and you know, it's just your brain dictate you that you would do this, and it's a surrogate image, you know, it's like you already done it. You feel that, so yeah, I already done it inside of you, but it's just in your brain dictate you to do these things, and you can beat these excitements with another one. It's really work, and that's it. Same with the alcohol. It's absolutely identical situation. When I go there as well, and when they just open their same person, because you know, in a pathological anatomy, they look in for everything. They open your head, your skull, and to see what's happened in your brain. So when they cut it down, skull, and open it and open cup of your head, so inside this was brain, but this moment when they open it on the two half, you know, they just cut it down with a special sword because of the bone here very strong, so they cut it down. When they open it, smell from brain, it was awful. It was same like person drink and next day what sort of smell he will have from his mouth. If you know about this, it's awful. If you smell person from next on the next day when they drink, you know, it's a smell, I don't know this word how to explain it, but it's awful smell. And when they open brain of this man, because I tell you, he died just after wedding, on the wedding day actually of his daughter, so he drink alcohol on the wedding. So when they open it, all our students, we stay and just all just close our doses. God, yes, it's awful. God, and our doctor, pathological anatomy, he said, why are you surprised? Of course, because it's a lot of blood goes through your brain and you have same smell like from your mouth, from your lung. You have same smell in your brain, of course. It's reason why you, when you drunk, you walking like this, shaking from one side to another, and because it's go into your brain, into your structure of your brain, which is answer for walking straight, and it's. After when this alcohol do the action for this part of brain, you shaking. So it's here, it's in your brain. Otherwise you wouldn't even feel any other emotions from alcohol, you know? So same day when I feel smell of this alcohol, and also from this smoke, I stop it. I don't drink, you know. Sometimes because tradition, because everything, I can put up my how you call it, glass with a little bit of wine or something like that, little bit, you know. It's and but I know exactly what it can cause, you know. But, okay, if you're doing it in once in a year and you know, imagine what is going to happen with you. So you can drink, of course. It's allowed everything, you know. But all the time think that, you know, dose of this alcohol is very important. So... so it's reason why I really don't smoke and don't drink. And somebody just want to enjoy a glass of wine. And if it's just a little bit and you have good structure of your brain and you can control just doing it. Everything allowed in this life. Nothing really bad. You don't harm anybody, and everything what you do, you know what you do, and you're doing it for yourself. But I tell you about my experience, and I think maybe it will help you to understand more what happened with addiction to these things. So, but we talk about smoking today, and so of course people, when they start in smoke, they you know, first because opinion of people around, you know, just if your friends is smoke, you also want to be same. I don't want to be, you know, somebody like not from my company, you know, just you also want smoke same like everybody's do from your friends. So and you know, and but you should understand it's a big business. The smoke, everything is business, you know. And so what would they want? They want that you start in smoke, that they want that you continue smoke, they want that you buy all the time your cigarettes and or tobacco. I don't know, everybody think that some, you know, just their choice, you know, they somebody think that the tobacco and they doing themselves less harm them, or don't know, it should be good tobacco or no good, you know, it's tobacco. And so they these businessmen, they just want that you continue with your addiction. It's their brain, very clever. They want good life. They want have a yacht, houses, goods, the best all in the world. Of course, they think about. about your addiction, about your health, about something? No, of course, now they can put on their cigarettes some sort of frightening pictures that smoking is harming you or something like that. But they still continue to do this business, you know? And from a long, long time ago, this business come to people, you know? And this business come from a long time ago, and it's worked really very well for you. And all stuff, you know, cigarettes, smoking, any stuff, they produce in such nice way, with a nice color packs of cigarettes, or this was same like this one, for example, with the face of King, and they call them King Edward, you know. What people would do when they see on the cigarette's face of their king? Of course, they want to be involved in this business. They want to be same like King Edward, you know, buy and smoke these cigarettes, you know. And all packs done very nice, beautiful, different colors. So it's take your attention, it's advertising, of course. And also, you know, even for women, it was specially done stuff for smoking, you know. You can see sometimes very nice with embroideries, cigarette lighters, together with a compact for, you know, for powder for his, for his face. You know, it's just exactly you can see the, for women done this stuff. For example, what I have at home here, you can see is for like an ashtray, and you can see cigarette lighter. You know, you can see that is. This is from Beechwood company, you know. I'm absolutely love porcelain of Beechwood. I would do video about this another time. But everybody was involved in this smoke business, because look at this, it's such beautiful stuff, and you would like that it stay on your table, beautifully done. But when you do this, do you think about harm of your body? No, you just want to buy something nice as everybody can buy, you know. It looks beautiful, really done very well. So actually they do this addiction looking more nicer. So from any countries, everywhere, you know, I have some here from China, you know, you have a lot of, we had somewhere, but at the moment I don't have a lot of different cigarette holders, you know. They done beautiful with hieroglyphs and nice pictures, or sometimes it's really a piece of art, pipes and everything, you know. They look so beautiful. Of course you want to be involved in this, of course you want to be very I don't know how you tell, go together with the time, you know. It's just absolutely do as everybody do, you know. You can see a cigarette holder, a pipe holder like this, Japanese. So they have a very nice pipe here. You can see it's some sort of fish here on the pipes, and done beautifully, and you can see it's very small, tiny. So it means you put not a lot of tobacco here, but they can do this more often because it's small, it's quickly gone. And you can see it's carved very nice, very well, you know. Everything take your attention and desire to have it, you know. So all this cigarette business, they always, you know, want to something that you buy cigarettes, so they just want that you will be involved, that you have excitement. And if you really want to be showing your riches or how you in this world, they produce even, you know, it can be gold from inlaid pipes and everything, you know, just they do posh items for smoking, everything to excite people, everything to involve into smoking. For example, I'll show to you, I have at the moment here to show to you. But there's this thing. When you see something like that, would you excited to have this smoking cabinet? Well, this was, yeah, it's 19th century, but you can see it's done so beautiful. And you can see even behind, it's like a piece of furniture, you know. And of course, this cabinet for smoking here is for coal, because you can see pipes is so small, so you need to all the time hold coal here, so to smoke your pipes, and here for ashes. And you can see how they engrave. Look at this, look at this beauty. Yes, of course it's very nice. And because they want to excite you, they wanted you be involved in smoking one way or another way. You can see it, you know, they make from long time ago smoking excited, you know. And when you have something like that, you can't stop smoking because it's nice something to do. You don't think about your health or something like that. Of course, a long time ago, they even don't know a lot of information how smoking harm our health. But this time, we already knew about this, and it's your responsibility, of course, for your health, for to be involved in this smoking business, is your responsibility. If you think that it's okay for you, just do this. If you think that you really can harm yourself and this addiction very strong, just beat this excitement from this smoking by other one. I don't know, go to travel, go to mountains, go to some sort of sport, which is with smoking you not possible to be a good sportsman, you know. You just do something like that. Try to find new excitements for your brain, because he was all the time, because a lot of advertising around, a lot of everything, you can see how they do smoking, looks very nice, you know. And but if really to say, you can win this your addiction if you will find something which is more stronger than smoking, you know. Try to find for you good addiction. I tell you already in my previous video that it's a lot of way to find another exciting things, and also your family should be near with you to help you in this, to beat this addiction with another one. With you know, go together dancing, go together somewhere, and competition with your friends in some or another way, you know. You always can find, just to switch it on your art in your brain, and you will to everything. You can manage with this. About 2 years ago, I think, or time goes so quick, or maybe already three, cousin of my husband lost her husband because he died from lung cancer, you know. And I talk with her. She visits us every summer, and I talk with her. You know how you feel, how you know alone, and because all life they live together, you know. And so, did you used to live alone or something like that? She said, no. I cry every day into my pillow. Of course, she used to live with her husband for so many years. I don't know. I don't remember how many, 47 or something. I already really forgot about this figure. But for so long time, she used to live. They have addiction to each other, you know. And when you lost this person, you really are looking lost in this world, you know. It's very difficult to lose somebody from your family. It's very, very sad feelings, and she still got it. And he can still live. He just go to pension. He even didn't enjoy his pension age. He was just 65. You know, he just starting, and he can use. He work all these years, and he think that he would enjoy his life on the pension, but it's not. Life is finished. He's smoking really very often. He's smoking. He produce himself these cigarettes with tobacco. I don't know how he's doing it. I've seen a few times, so it's just, that's it. Just because of this. So one person all the time cry, another is not exist anymore. So, and of course, we talk about addiction, we talk about brain here, and for this time I finish my video. And if you think that is interesting video for you, so you can watch in my another one. It will be for another object. If you think that your friends have problem with this addiction and you don't, so show them this video, suggest them to watching it, and talk together about, because it's very important, talk together about addictions and find out way together how to go out of this. And I showed to you in my example that it's possible, and it's a lot of people stop it as well. Same like a wife of this man who died, cousin of my husband, she also smoked with him really for so many years, but when he died, she been so angry on this smoking. She was so angry because it's taken from her nearest, dearest person in her life, father of her children. And she went so angry on this smoking, and she stopped. She smoked as well for so many years, I don't know. For how many, about 50 years she smoked. Maybe a bit less, I don't know, but about this. And she stopped it. So it's possible. Because angry, another excitements of being beat those so many years addiction for smoking. Because her emotion was more stronger. Her anger was much stronger than her desire to go and smoking, and she stopped it. And there's a lot of ways can help you to stop smoking. You just, if you want it really, you can find it. And don't forget, talk with your nearest people who can help you to stop it, with whom you can discuss this problem. It's very, very important. You must be ready to stop smoking. Before you stop smoking, you can find some sort of excitement before, because if you just stop because you just you know, just think, oh yeah, I should stop because I will have this problem or something like that, and you didn't find anything for your brain to excitement you, brain would have a stress. You must swap. You must absolutely found something which is swapped those excitements from smoking. Because one person I know, he stopped it because, you know, he just think, oh, I should probably stop smoking, and he didn't found it, and he have a really big stress for his body, from his brain, because brain absolutely was in stress, and he have sugar diabetes after stress, because for him it's really stress, because all this nicotine go into your brain, into your body, plus addiction, you know, it's a stress. But first things you must find for your brain something which is you can swap, is the first thing. Then you will be really successful, because, you know, I think it's really one of way for any addiction. You must to find something first which is you can swap one addiction to another. If you really fed up with your addiction, to bad addiction, so first since you found something which is you can swap one to another, more excitements would bring to your brain different feelings, so brain will be happy with this. I hope you understand what I'm talking about, and if not, just ask questions on the video, and I'm really happy that you're watching it until end, and so I hope you come back to watching another of my videos about other objects, and I really hope that you already my friend, and I love you to bits, and at the moment, bye bye, see you next time.